What's up, divas? And what's up, divos? It's your girl April, and you already know it is Real Talk Wednesday. So in case you guys don't know about Real Talk Wednesday and you are new to my channel, every Wednesday we have a Real Talk episode from our viewers who've been watching me for however long. They do send me emails needing advice, opinions, or what have you, or my thoughts. You can always send an email to me at MuffinIsMyLovers2012@gmail.com. When you do, make sure you put in the subject line, Real Talk. So it's all about Real Talk. Some people call it story time. Well, you know what? Real Talk and story time is totally different, because story time is basically about their own situations and they tell you a story about it. Real Talk is some real talk, just the same thing, but this is just basically different. You need some advice, whatever, you're going to email me. And I'm just, it is what it is. It's blunt. I'm not going to filter anything. I'm not going to say what you want me to say, and if you don't like what I say, you may not like me anymore, and you may unsubscribe. But hey, it's real talk, so that's what it be. So yeah, you can always send me an email to MuffinIsMyLovers2012@gmail.com. So, before you girls ask, I do get a lot of emails and private messages and questions on my Instagram whenever I wear this hair. What unit is that? What unit is that? It's not synthetic. It's a wig that I actually made using AliExpress hair like some months ago. I balayaged it, so that's why it's different colors. And this is what it is. It's just a unit that I made a minute ago. Though I think I'm going to add some more toner to it to lighten it up a little bit, but I do love it. But I will tell you this right here is starting to piss me off. Only because, well, the comb broke in half. The metal comb just broke, so it's not holding on. And so, yeah, I have to fix that. I've been supposed to have fixed it when I first made the wig, but I never did. So now it's really starting to piss me off. But anywho, today's drink is a mango vodka with some orange juice in a purple plastic cup. And today's makeup look is using Too Faced Bon Bon palette, which I'm gonna be honest and say it's kind of boring to me, okay? And I say that because I love the peanut butter and jelly palette. Like, that palette gives me life. But this one right here ain't really nothing too special about it. Like, it smells good and all, but it's kind of boring. And for $50, you could have get something else, a whole bunch of something else, and get the same colors. So this one is really not doing it for me at all. Girls, watch my makeup tutorials. The last few I have been doing have been a lot of Too Faced products, because I'm like a huge Too Faced fan. I fucking love Too Faced, okay? I love Too Faced cosmetics, so I do like to wear it. But this palette right here, not repping Too Faced at all. However, their peach palette, Peach Kisses, I think that's what it's called. I can't remember. But that palette is beautiful, and it will be released on the 29th of this month, March. So that is $49 as well. So hopefully I can get it in time before it sells out, because it's already sold out on TooFaced.com. So yes, that is the look for today, along with some Ofra Cosmetics lip liner and plum, and some Ulta lipstick, I think it was. Something like that. But yeah, so let's get into this real talk. Okay, so I got quite a few long ones today. So this one right here was real interesting. So first of all, she put her own topic, what it should be for the show. Topic: my sister's dope boy, no good bum ass baby daddy. Okay, you can call me Alexis. Am I being too harsh? So she's asking me, is she being too harsh? And then she's gonna explain herself. So about a year ago, my brother told me, our youngest sister, I'm 33, my brother is 28, and our sister is 25. My brother told me our youngest sister Janice was pregnant. By who? Nobody knew, but my mother heard it was But my brother heard it was some wannabe trap king. I knew she was dealing with this dude because of Instagram and brief conversations with my family, telling me that she stays gone days at a time. But when I asked my parents about this dude, they said, who? She has been dealing with this guy for at least 6 months and never even mentioned this dude's name. So finally the cat got out of the bag and my brother did not hesitate to fill us in about this dude's lifestyle. So I confront her in an email because I know I have no filter and we are 1,500 miles away. And I didn't want her to have the opportunity to hang up on me. I tell her that she's a college grad and she should be focusing on getting a job in her field. But instead, she's been laid up with some so-called dope boy that nobody knows. Not to mention the fact that she has been posting ratchet pictures of her and her ratchet homegirls in random hotels, hanging out at the pools, getting drunk, and then hitting clubs up. Talking about you're living up some life upscale lifestyle. Trick, you're at the Holiday Inn Express and a $20 cover club. Bye-bye. To make a long story short, my email was a 5-paragraph essay directed to her. But she emails me back and tells me that she is showing Dope Boy the email because it was in part about him too. So there is the paragraph where he addresses me saying how he is doing his thing, he has a BMW, etc. To tell you the truth, I can't remember everything he said because I blacked out. I responded with an email that started, I don't know you, so don't you ever address me. Well, I never got a response back. I should have known my sister would side with him when I saw the tattoo of his name on her wrist. But you know what? She has never behaved like this before. What I mean is, ever since she started hanging with her ghetto-ass friends, she started acting ghetto. Getting drunk, partying, disregarding her bachelor's degree, and working on an entry-level customer service job. Getting tangled up with so-called side chicks who like to bust her car windows out. The thing that is so disturbing is that we raised her in the suburbs. Why is she fascinated with this ghetto lifestyle all of a sudden is beyond me. But when she showed that bum the email I sent her, an email between two sisters, I realized she was in too deep and had picked that loser over her family. Now the baby is here. They were living with his cousin and she was supposedly getting a job, but that never happened and she wound up moving back in with my parents. She still hasn't got a job in her field and even quit a steady job she had. Why? I don't know. A friend of the family has started babysitting the baby when she found another dead end job. But come to find out, they got into a little tiff about Janice because Janice said that she could not only give her... Come to find out... The friend got, my sister and her friend got into a little tiff because Janice said, who's my sister, she can only give her $20 of the $40 she owes her for the week because she was going out that night. Let's not forget that I recently paid her car note, cell phone bill, bought diapers and formula because she didn't have any money. She must have had something because she was turned at the club on Snapchat. Wow. I started to feel some type of way last week. Why am I paying her bills and taking care of her baby when she has a dude? A couple days ago, I asked her via text if he had a job. And even though the status said, read, I got no reply. In conversations with my dad, I hear she claims he gives her money for the baby. But he's been by the house to babysit his own baby. And they have never, not once, seen him bring anything for the baby. Then again, he doesn't drive for whatever reason, so Janice has to go pick him up 30 minutes away if he needs to babysit. Our cousins have taken her to pick him up in the hood around the corner from some chick he is supposed to be dealing with. The other day, my brother's colleague said, I didn't know Janice was dealing with Dope Boy. He's my cousin. Then our cousin confronted her about her ghetto Facebook statuses that indirectly addresses females and lets Janice know that it makes her look beat. She also told Janice about one of his side chicks and Janice replied, oh, he's not cheating with her. He's just using her because she has money. The okie doke. Hashtag the okie doke. I have decided that I am not paying another bill or buying Jack. By contributing financially, I feel I am enabling her. It doesn't help that she ignores me and disregards attempts by family to get her to open her eyes. I said, we can speak about the baby, but anything else, miss me on that shit. I don't have anything to say to her. Am I being too harsh? So, Alexis's sister, Janice, was studying to go to school for a bachelor's degree. However, she got herself trapped up with so-called Dope Boy. She'd been taking ratchet-ass photos on social media, getting her car windows busted out, got pregnant, knew the nigga was knew him for 6 months, got his name tattooed on her wrist, got a baby with him. He's claiming that he driving a BMW, he do his thing, he get money. But here's the thing, you was pregnant, she was pregnant by him, and they living with his cousin. If you were some nigga, he's supposed to be a dope boy, and he's supposed to be getting money, and he driving a BMW, why is you living with his family members? Why y'all ain't living in your own shit? And why did you have to move back home to your motherfucking parents? So, her sister want to know if she being too harsh because she don't want to fucking deal with her no more. The girl is posting pictures up on Snapchat, turns up at the clubs, can't even pay her a whole fee for daycare, which is like $40 a week, which ain't shit. Okay? $40 a week. I wish a motherfucker would charge somebody $40 a week. Everybody be at the daycare, okay? Everybody's kids be at that daycare. But she going to pick him up. What happened to his BMW? I thought he had a BMW. Now she picking him up so he can come over and babysit. He with some other girl. He not cheating with her. He only with her because he using her for the money. Like she said, the okie doke. And basically, she just fucked up. Here's the thing. Is she being too harsh? I'm going to tell you what, Alexis. You are being just right. Now here's the thing. She done got caught up. She done been raised in the suburbs. You know what's so funny? I have a cousin who was raised in the suburbs. She was raised real good. But for some reason, she liked to come back to the hood where I lived at in the projects and fuck with the dope boys. And this is when we was teenagers. So, you know what I'm saying? She would love to come to the hood. She went to a good private school, Catholic school, all-girl Catholic school in Manhattan. But she would love to come to the projects and be around the ratchet bitches that sit on a bench all day, that's still sitting on the bench all motherfucking day. And she liked to deal with the drug dealers, the dope boys. That's whatever. They weren't called dope boys when I was growing up, but that's what they were. So she started skipping school, started being a flunky, didn't graduate, had to get a GED, struggled. And all she's attracted to is fucking jackasses, lowlife, scumbags, dope boys, nobodies. But she finally made her way in life, got it together, met a nice man. He's an engineer. What does she do? As soon as he goes to work, because he travels for his job, she gets one of the ex-dope boy boyfriends of hers, and she starts cheating on with him. And there you have it. So now you done fucked up your life. You done fucked up your kid's life because you want to be with the dope boys. You know something? You can tell somebody till they blue in the face, till you blue in the face, pink, purple, whatever the fuck color you want to be, stop fucking with these lame ass dudes. What the fuck is wrong with you? But they're not going to see you. They're not going to hear you. They're not going to feel anything until they decide to. So it's funny because a lot of the girls that are raised in these so-called suburbs where they've been raised in good family surroundings, And so forth. They always want to peddle their asses out to the hood and see what it's like. They always want to get a roughneck. You know the song, roughneck, gotta get a roughneck. Maybe not all of y'all do know it because it was probably before your time. However, the good girls, or not even the good girls, the ones who have been raised in these holy environments, okay, because that's what the fuck I'm going to call it, where they don't really know what's on the outside of the real world, what's in the real world, what's outside of that door. They always want to fucking peddle their way to the other side of the fence to see what it's like. And for some reason, they just fucking love it. Now, for those of us who have grown up in the hood all our life, we the motherfuckers that is trying to get the fuck out of the shit because we don't want to be there no more. But the ones that ain't grew up in the hood, they want to be in the hood. They want to pedal their way and get into the hood. Like, it is something spectacular to be around the dope boys and be around the dope girls or trap kings or whatever the fuck you want to call it. They want to see what that lifestyle is like. And for some reason, they really fucking are, like, fascinated with it. A lot of times with shit like that, when she's turned out with these ratchet ass bitches, it's because her friends are not about that lifestyle and she feels like she's at home. She wants to be a part of something. You know what I'm saying? She wants to feel like she's sowing her wild oats. She wants to be a part of something. Now here it is, she done got a name tattooed, she done slept with this boy, she got a baby by the dope boy Trap King, and he ain't even doing shit for his baby. Why don't he sell his so-called BMW and take care of his fucking child? You know what I'm saying? So she's living back at home and she's basically leeching off your parents. So you sent her the email, and what was kind of fucked up, it, That shit was kind of messed up. Why would she show her boyfriend that? You've only been with him for 6 months and you want to show your boyfriend, which is so-called blood relative who cares about you, who you mean the world to. You want to go and show him the email that your sister wrote and then you want to allow him to respond back to it? If that were me, I would have flipped out and spazzed out, and I probably wouldn't have fucked with her for a minute. I'm not going to say I wouldn't fuck with her anymore because, of course, that's my little sister. And we all make mistakes. But she's just in a world of her own. It's fascinating to her. And she still finds that shit fascinating because here he is. He on another part of town. He messing with some other girl, using her for the money. And she is, like, stuck in the clouds. He got her so brainwashed that she don't even know what to do with herself. And she got ratchets that she's hanging out with and Snapchatting with and showing it off and turning up at the club. There's nothing wrong with turning up, okay? I'm not going to knock turning up. Everybody need to turn up sometime. However, there's a way you go about turning up, too. You know what I'm saying? Don't make yourself look like an asshole turning up. And then you got everybody embarrassed. Your family look like shit. Your family looking embarrassed because you acting stupid on social media and you think it's cute. But when they that young, Alexis, you really can't tell them nothing because they feel like they so grown. But I go to college and I'm getting my bachelor's degree and I'm 25 years old, bitch. I'm grown. You not fucking grown if you got other people taking care of your baby. You not grown if you still living at home. You not grown if you hanging out with the ratchets, turning up, doing dumb shit on social media. That is not the act of a grown ass person. That is the act of a child who is trying to reach out for help. You're not harsh. Sometimes you gotta be really harsh. Maybe you should be even harsher with her and don't even talk to her about her baby. And I know that's your niece or nephew or what have you. That's you're the auntie and you're concerned about your blood relative, the baby. However, I wouldn't even give her any type of response because she's going to use the baby as a scapegoat to get to you. She's going to use the baby as a reason to communicate with you. Sometimes you got to cut off all ties in order for that person to learn a lesson. Eventually they come around and it may not be when you want them to come around, but eventually they will come around. So me personally, I will cut off all ties with her until she can get her shit together. She got a dead ass end job. She got a dead end job and she dropped out of school or what? She's not even doing what she's supposed to do because of some dope boy. Like, really, does she really honestly believe that this is going to last? Like, if he really gave two fucks about her and their baby, then his dope boy ass would have an apartment for them and a car for them and some shit for them and they would be all right and he would get his shit together. But he really doesn't care. She's got him coming and babysitting the baby. I wouldn't even let that motherfucker in the house. That's one thing your parents should do, and unfortunately that is his child. But me as a parent, if it were I, April, you wouldn't be coming up in my house because if you got the reputation and the lifestyle of being a dope boy and everybody else knows it, you don't need to come up in my house and babysit my grandchild. No, 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 no. If you want to babysit, then you're going to have to go somewhere else. Go to your mama's house and babysit. Go to one of your family members and babysit. But I wouldn't even let him up in my parents' house simply for the fact you don't know what he's bringing up in there. You don't know who's watching him. It could be the feds, the police, some type of enemy, some niggas that don't like him. Following him, you don't know who could be watching him, okay, and following him to your family's house. So I wouldn't even let him come to my family's house. You don't know what he could have on him. He could have drugs on him. He could have a weapon on him. You really don't know. So me personally, he wouldn't be coming to my family's house and babysitting no fucking baby. And that's just me. That's my personal opinion. Also, like I said, if she don't want to communicate with you like that, and she don't want to get her shit together, and she think that she rule the world, and her and Dope Boy is going to be like Bonnie and Clyde, like Jay-Z and Beyonce, then let her continue to think that way. Because what's going to happen next is her little young ass going to have to get on welfare and take care of her baby because her Dope Boy boyfriend going to go to jail. Oh, excuse me, not her Dope Boy boyfriend. Her boyfriend and somebody else's boyfriend and somebody else's boyfriend. Because I guarantee you that nigga's not just fucking her. He's got this bitch over here who he's using for the money. And then he's got some bitch back here, the side chick, and then some other shit. And if she continues to go ahead and live that lifestyle, she must love to get her fucking car windows broken out over some ratchet bitches. Here's one thing that I don't deal with. I don't deal with ratchet bitches. There's a lot of motherfucking ratchet bitches out there, and there might be some watching this motherfucking video. So if you feel offended because I said there might be some ratchet ass bitches watching this video, then I'm not really going to apologize for that because it's truth be told, there are some ratchet ass bitches out there in the world who watch YouTube, who be on YouTube, who on any type of social media. There are ratchet ass bitches out there. And that's one thing that I don't deal with is ratchet ass bitches, okay? My circle is like this. It ain't even a fucking circle, it's a dot. I got one fucking friend and she live out here in fucking Arizona. Excuse me, I have two because my daughter is my best friend. But, and my man is my other best friend, so I got three friends. However, I don't really deal with the ratchet bitches. We're not gonna be on social media blowing ourselves up, making ourselves look like foolery, fuckery, bullshit. That's just not what we do. However, in the long run, if you continue to go ahead and be on social media, taking Snapchats and Instagram photos with ratchets and doing ratchet ass shit, you're going to have a name for yourself. And that's just social media. And it's really hard to come back sometimes with social media. You don't want to be a part of somebody else's social media page and they got you lined up as the thought crew. You know what I'm saying? The thought crew, whatever. You know what I'm saying? Whatever you want to call it, you don't want to be lined up as the thought crew. So let your sister continue on, Alexis, doing the shit she want to do. You're not going to be able to tell her because she feel like you think you know too much and you know it all. And at that age, they think they know every fucking thing. Trust and believe. We was both there at that time in our life. I wasn't 25 feeling that way, but at like 16 and 17, I felt like I knew everything until I got snapped back into reality. But I don't think you're too harsh at all. You do what you have to do, but I'm going to just give you a word of advice. I wouldn't even have no communication with her. Even if it has to do with the baby. If you want to know about her baby and so forth, then communicate with your parents. I'm pretty sure since she lives back at home, they will fill you in on any type of news or any type of new agenda that's going on with your sister and her baby's life. I wouldn't even communicate with her because you don't want her to use that against you. So, yes, let Alexis know what would you do in the situation if your sister was dating the dope boy. Okay, so here we go. Hey, April, please give me some advice. I have been seeing this guy for about seven months now, and he is already head over heels in love with me. I tell him that it is way too soon to be in love, but he said that he just can't help it. I know that he truly cares about me. One day, I snuck into his phone and read his messages, and they were all from women who he told he was no longer interested in because he is pursuing me. He's constantly shouting me out on social media as the love of his life, but gets mad because I don't do the same. I care about him, but I'm not ready to make it official. It seems like lately everything he does is beginning to annoy me. He comes over my house for the weekend and he does not bring anything with him, meaning no toothbrush, no change of clothes, etc. He gets in the shower and puts the same dirty drawers back on. He also gets in the shower without a washcloth, and that annoys the hell out of me. A grown man can't properly wash his ass without any type of rag. One day I got so upset and I just told him everything. The next time he came to my house, he finally brought an overnight bag. I am still kind of annoyed that I had to tell a 25-year-old man to bring clothes and a toothbrush. He still does not use a rag in the shower, and his ass stinks. Literally. I told my friend about it, and she said that's a white people thing. They do not use a rag in the shower. I know that's not all the way true because I have many white friends who use wash rags. Another thing that annoys me is that he is always rushing me for no reason. If we go to the store, he's like, hurry up, let's go. But there is no reason to rush. He rushes me to get out of the car, to leave the house. It's annoying. It's not like we are running late for anything. One day I yell, stop fucking rushing me, damn it. And I think it hurt his feelings. Yeah, he still does it. He is a good guy and would give me the world if he could, but now I just feel annoyed every time I'm around him. I know he will be extremely hurt if I end everything. I don't know what to do. Please help. You can call me Charisse and him Brian. So Charisse is annoyed. She has been seeing this guy Brian for 7 months, and basically he is head over heels with her. He has been shouting her out on social media. She has went in his phone and seen that he has told every woman that he is not interested in them because he is pursuing her. However, However, he has been coming over to her house and staying the weekend and ain't bringing nothing but himself and the clothes that he got on. No bag, no nothing. So she's basically like, he is wearing the same dirty ass drawers. He ain't got no toothbrush. He ain't got no wash rag. He ain't doing nothing until she had to basically go off and tell him about himself. So he finally came with a bag, but he still ain't got no washcloth. And I'm pretty sure that Sharice would give him a washcloth had he asked for one, okay? The other thing is, she says that his ass literally stinks. I'm not really sure, Sharice, how you know his ass literally stinks unless you smelling it. However, maybe you just know that. I don't even want to go there, but you know what? He's annoying the shit out of her, and he's rushing her. So she don't know what to do. She don't know what to do. I'm going to tell you something, Sharice. First of all, why he don't ask you for no wash rag? Is he using your soap? Is he using shower gel? Is he using your soap? And is he washing in his ass crack with your bar of soap? Or is he using a shower gel? And you need to say to him, listen, you don't have to be rude. But when he's getting in the shower, just be like, here, babe, here's a washcloth for you to use when you take a shower. And let's see if he uses it. You know what I'm saying? Don't be rude and don't be like, oh, why you don't use no wash rag to wash your stinking ass? Your ass fucking stink. What you do is say to him, here, babe, here's a washcloth for you because I know you're about to take the shower. You know, so you can wash up. You don't have to say wash up properly. Just give him a washcloth so that he knows. You know what I'm saying? He might have been kind of nervous and scared to bring over his own things to sleep over with. Because sometimes when people come over with their own things, they kind of feel like they intruding. You know what I'm saying? Me personally, I probably might feel that way. But I'm telling you what, if I'm coming to spend a night at your house, I'm bringing my toothbrush and I'm bringing me some change of clothes. All right? And if you feel some type of way about that shit, well, bitch, I don't know what the fuck to tell you. Because you knew I was coming to spend the night and I need to brush my motherfucking teeth and I need to change my clothes and wash my ass. I'll come with my own shower gel and my own little loaf of sponge and shit like that. And probably my own wash rag and my own baby wipes because, you know, I gotta change. A bitch gotta take her makeup off and all my facial cleansing stuff. However, he might felt a little uncomfortable just coming and just bringing his shit in off the gate. Because some people, unlike you, may feel like, wait, whoa, whoa, dude, you doing a little bit too much. What you trying to move the fuck in? And he might felt that way. So you gotta kind of, you know, at least you told him and now he's bringing stuff over. He may not have known how to approach you about bringing his own things in to your home. You know what I'm saying? Because you may have taken it a certain way. But God, nigga, come wash your ass if you can come stay over. Don't put the same drawers on. Is he washing the drawers? If he washed his drawers overnight and let them, you know, drip dry, then that's a different thing. But if he ain't even doing that, just like you said, he put the same dirty ass drawers on, then hey. Some men don't think much of it. You know what I'm saying? They put the same drawers on. But if you just said his ass literally stinks, then bitch, what the fuck, okay? Sharice, if his ass literally stinks, I'm sorry, I can't really fuck with nobody that stinks, okay? Because then that says a lot about you. However, you telling your friends and shit, and your friends is like, that's what white people do. White people don't just not use rags. I've seen many black people that just don't use wash rags either. And you just are some black bitches like my cousin who I just don't like, or her dirty fucking ass. She don't even wash. The bitch don't brush her teeth. She don't wash the sleep out of her eyes. She dirty. She just look like pond scum all the way around, okay? And she know I don't like her, okay? And she's too motherfucking faced, okay? So, yeah, the bitch know I don't like her. So, black folk don't use wash rags neither. Some black folk don't use wash rags neither. But here's the thing. He's starting to annoy you because you're not really feeling him like that. And he may be a little bit too overbearing on you. What you need to do to tell Brian is, hey, you know, I really like you and I care about you, but can we just take it a little bit more slower? Because I would like to get to know you a lot more before we rush into things. Rushing into things may ruin a good thing. And I don't want anything to be ruined. I want us to take our time to get to know one another, okay? And that's all you gotta do is tell him that. You're not kicking him to the curb. You're just telling him how you feel. And that's why he's annoying you. Trust me, I've been there. Niggas will annoy you because sometimes the love that they want to give you or the affection they want to give you sometimes is overwhelming and you just not into it like that. You just not feeling it like that. You may not be in the mood. You just may not be feeling it like that. But you really need to tell him, hey, let's not rush. I like you. I want to get to know you a little bit more before I make a commitment. When I say before I make a commitment, it does not mean that I'm cheating on you or I'm doing anything like that outside the box. But, you know, we're both young and I just want to get to know you. You know what I'm saying? Let's build together. Sometimes when you rush into shit, it just don't work out. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, everybody want to be happily ever after. But like you said, you're not ready for a commitment. You young, and I can respect that. Because don't nobody want no kids all the time. Don't nobody want to be tied down all the time. Some people want to do their own thing, so they wild oats, live their life, and not have a ball and chain fucking tugging them the fuck around, getting on their last goddamn nerve on some real shit, okay? Now me, I'm 42, so I'm settled down and I'm happy the way I am. However, some people just not ready, and 25 is still young. But if the nigga ass literally stink, boo, like I said, this is what you're gonna do. When he come over to spend the weekend and you know he about to get in the shower, get him a wash off. You know what I would do, Cherise? Here's something even better, something way better. Go out and buy him some men's shower gel and one of the little loafer sponges. Get him one of those and let him know, hey babe, look what I bought for you, so when you come over, you got this. That's even better than giving him a washcloth, because now you just let him know, I bought you your own shit, and let's see if he uses it. You know what I'm saying? Give it to him when he's about to get in the shower. Let him know, hey babe, look what I bought for you. I was out, so I bought this for you because I thought you would like it, so when you come over, you got something of your own. Let's see how that works out. That is like the easiest way. It's an icebreaker. You're not hurting anybody's feelings. You're not letting him know his ass literally stinks. And if he doesn't use that shit, bitch, then let that nigga know you need to wash your motherfucking ass. Because I don't really want to be with dirty motherfuckers. Or just let them down easy and say, you know what? I'm really not ready for a relationship right now. And I really think it's best that we remain friends. That's all you gotta do, girl. Trust me, it'll work. Mm-hmm. So let Cherise know what you would do about stinking butt Brian, okay? Stinking butt Brian. Mm-mm. Okay. So here is the last one for the day. Hey, April, I love your videos and I've been watching you for years. I changed the names in the email already. My name is London and I am a mother of two. I just had my youngest son a month ago and I met their father over 10 years ago. We were in an on and off relationship for 10 years. We had our oldest year four and got engaged year five. Oh, okay. We had our oldest child year four and we got engaged year five. I got pregnant with our youngest last year. My issue is he keeps coming in and out of our lives. One minute he wants our family, the next minute he didn't. Which is how I got pregnant last year with our youngest, because he wanted a family. He doesn't even claim the youngest and refuses to take a DNA test since he keeps saying he's not positive he's his. I already put in a request with our court system to do a DNA test and set up child support, but I'm waiting for a court date. At this point, our youngest is 1 month old. Whenever he calls, he is only interested in our 7-year-old, and he constantly calls me names and wants to argue. Now he's threatening to take our oldest because he's moved on with his life and has a fiance now that I knew nothing about after being with me for over 10 years. For the past 7 years, I have allowed him to get our son whenever he had time, but he has never had time for our son in the past 6 years. Alone, he hasn't kept our son overnight or for a full 24-hour period, but now he wants custody. He found time to go on first-class vacations, sit courtside at basketball games, buy new cars, and date, but was never around to spend time with our son. It got so bad that I don't allow him to tell my son that he's coming to get him anymore, because I will pack his bags and our child will be waiting at the door for his dad to get him and he wouldn't even show up. I will call him, text him, he wouldn't answer, our son would be in tears. He's forgotten our son at daycare on multiple occasions, even left him in the house alone at 2 years old sick to go and get food when I was working up the street and could have just brought it to him. I do everything alone, literally, and I don't complain. I was still nice enough to include him in every function my son has participated in, and he doesn't show up. I'm sick of his threats and his harassment. My issue is, if you are happy so with your life, why are you bothering me and trying to take my child away that you see once every 2 months and talk to maybe 3 times a month on the max? He pays child support for him, and he says he's tired of paying me money to babysit our child. I gave birth to him alone and raised him alone. And at this point, I just want to pack up my children and disappear. No one in his family acknowledged my pregnancy with our youngest. At this point, I feel as though they condone his behavior from him being as an absent dad to our 7-year-old. To leave him leaving me after 10 years and getting me pregnant again and having a secret relationship for the past 2 years, even though he was with me, to now not acknowledge our 1-month-old, I just want to be left alone. Just have him pay the child support and continue to be an absent dad like he's been. I don't understand why he thinks he can leave me and take my child after threatening me, after treating me the way he has done for 10 years. What would you do? Wow. So she didn't give me a name. We're just going to call her Sophia. So Sophia has been with this guy for 10 years, on and off, in and out of her life. They got a 7-year-old and they got a 1-month-old. He don't acknowledge the 1-month-old because he thinks it's not his. And here's the thing. He don't really even acknowledge the 7-year-old, if you ask me, because he doesn't even come around like that. He doesn't show up. He leaves the boy, little boy, at daycare on multiple occasions. How do you fucking leave your kid at daycare? Okay, left him in the house so he can go get something to eat. How the fuck do you do that dumb shit? He don't come and get the little boy when he says he's gonna come get him. So the little boy's left sitting by the door waiting in tears. Doesn't respond to any functions. He's always invited, but he doesn't respond. Now this nigga got a fiance and he's trying to get custody of the kid. What would I do? I would slap the fucking black off of his ass. He would have no black on him. All you would see is bare skin. He would be clear by the time I finish smacking the shit out of him. Smacking his ass down, okay? Smack the shit out of him so fucking hard that you could see through his goddamn skin. Like, that's how hard I would smack the color off his motherfucking ass. What would I do? I would let him try me. Because first of all, these men go around, they feel like they can do whatever they want. But here's the thing. As long as you allow them to, they are going to fuck you in the ass dry with no lubrication. Okay? Never let nobody fuck you over, man or female. You don't allow nobody to get the better part of you. You want to fucking try to step on my toes, nigga? I'ma step on your motherfucking feet. And by the end of the day, I'ma step and walk all over you. Now, if he wants to go ahead and threaten you and harass you, this is what I would do for his ass, his dumb ass. Since he wants to threaten and harass you, I would press charges on him. And that way, when we go to court, I would have all my documents, my ducks in a row, so this nigga know you're not about to get nobody's custody or nothing. You don't be there. You're threatening me. Here's the proof in the pudding on that. That's one thing that I would do. Every document that you bring into court is going to better help you. If he's texting you and he's texting you harassing and threatful things, I would keep those texts. I would take screenshots of them because, you know, after a certain amount of time, some of the texts do disappear. So I would take screenshots of the text messages and I would save those. I would save all of the actual voicemails. So what, as to save the voicemails, you know, after 30 days, you got to keep resaving them. So, excuse me, because my allergies are acting up. I would save the voicemail so that way I would keep all the proof that I have for this man. So that way when we do go to court, it's all documented. Because he's just running his mouth right now. I'm pretty sure he's probably not going to try to get custody of your kid. He's probably just doing this to threaten you because you want child support for you guys' 1-month-old. And he doesn't want to give it to you because that's why he's claiming he doesn't know if it's his. If he doesn't know it's his, why doesn't he want to take the DNA test? What dumb ass? He's a dumb ass. Like, he doesn't want to take the DNA test like she stated because he doesn't know if it's his. The last time I remember, that's what DNA was for, to find out if that was your motherfucking little offspring, right? So you have your day in court, but I wouldn't feed into any of his bullshit. What I would do, these are the things that I would do. I'm not going to allow you to keep threatening me and saying you're going to take my kid. I wouldn't even get up and disappear neither. Though, even if you disappeared, Sophia, and got up and moved away, I'm pretty sure it wouldn't matter to him because he doesn't pay the little boy that much attention as it is. So do you really think that it would matter to him? He probably wouldn't even know that you disappeared just that easy. Probably be like a month or so that went by, and then he would probably realize, oh, she's not around anymore. Where's my son? You know what I'm saying? That's when he would probably realize that. So I wouldn't even disappear. What I would do is I would go ahead and document everything that he's been doing to you and every time that he's supposed to call your son or come get your son and he doesn't, I will keep a log of that. So that way when you do go to court, here's the proof. This is when you were supposed to come get him, but you didn't. I called you at such and such time and you did not answer. I would document everything. Sometimes people may think that that's just doing too much, but sometimes doing too much is doing the right fucking thing, especially when it comes to your children and their livelihood and how they're treated. It's not fair to these kids that are brought into this world that their parents don't want to barely pay them any attention. They didn't ask to be brought here. So do your fatherly duties and your responsibilities and do what the fuck you're supposed to. You can't get custody of somebody that you don't even take care of, that you don't even see, you barely even fucking know. And as for this nigga who's got some fiance bitch, let him have the fiance bitch. Because you know what? If he's been cheating on you all that time and you and him haven't had a relationship and then now all of a sudden he's engaged to some fucking bitch, let him go ahead and marry the bitch. Because I guarantee you, karma is a motherfucker. And what's going to happen is he is going to reap what he sows. And in the long end, he's going to get what his ass fucking deserves. I wouldn't really even worry about him so much. And as for being left the fuck alone, bitch, please. Tell his ass to leave you the fuck alone or else you're going to go ahead and report his ass to the motherfucking police because you're not going to stand for this shit no more. Some people feel like as long as you allow them to walk on your toes and do what the fuck they want to do to you, they're going to go ahead and keep continuously doing that shit. Let me tell you something. A motherfucker gets tired of people trying to walk all over them. Okay, I'm one of those people. I'm a very nice person, and though I may come across as very aggressive, I've been told many times that I'm very aggressive. I have no filter, and I am very aggressive. However, I would give my last to anybody and try to make them happy and help anybody in any way I could. But sometimes your kindness gets taken for weakness, and motherfuckers try to walk all over you. And that's the shit that I don't condone. You ain't about to walk all over me. I'll allow it. I won't even allow it. I have allowed it in my past. But after a while, that shit changes. That changes the type of person that you are. You know what I'm saying? You get real aggressive. You get really fucking numb to a lot of shit. And you just don't put up with a lot of shit. And sometimes, not speaking up right away can really kind of like hurt you in the long run. If you let shit bottle up and bottle up and continuously take shit, it'll fuck you over in the end, and it's not a good thing. So speak your mind, document everything that you have to document for this dude, and make sure you got all your ducks in a row. And if you need to slap the shit out of the nigga, slap the shit out of the nigga. So on that note, I hope you girls enjoyed the video. Leave all your comments below, and if you want to hit me up, you can always hit me up on MuffinIsMyLovers2012@gmail.com. So on that note, stay diva and divalicious, and I'll see you girls soon on my next video.